Hello viewers, in today's video I will show you the procedure of finding inverse of a matrix using elementary row operations. Let capital A is equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. This is a square matrix. We need to find its inverse. So we will use row operation to find the inverse of this square matrix. Now we know to find the inverse, we can write capital A is equal to I3 into A. Why I3? Because A is a 3 by 3 square matrix. So we write I3. So place the value of A, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, then A31, A32 and A33. Your I is equal to 100010001 into A. Now we will use elementary row operations to find the inverse of this matrix. Our main motto is to convert this matrix A, that is transform this matrix A into I matrix, and automatically your I3 will be converted to a matrix B, which will be the inverse of A. So step one will be make A11 is equal to 1. That is, the first element of the first row and first column should be is equal to 1. To make it a I3, I need 100010001. So we need to make A11 is equal to 1. Now the process that we can use by using first one will be, if A11 is not equal to 1, and if you find that the element A21 or A31, any one of these two is equal to 1, then we can replace R1 by R3. That is, by writing R1 replaced by RI, where RI is any row I is equal to 2 or 3. You can replace R1 by R2 or R1 by R3. If the elements A211 or 21 or A231 is 1, then you can replace row 1 by row 2 or row 1 by row 3. So by using R1 replaced by RI, where I can be 2 or 3, or you can use this operation, R1 changes to R1 plus lambda into RI. By using any row, you can make it 1. Suppose it is 5 and it is 4. If I subtract R1 minus R2, I will get 1. So you can use the operation, R1 changes to R1 plus lambda into RI, where I can be any row 2 or 3. Or we can multiply your row 1 by a suitable constant lambda. Suppose if it is 2, if I need to make it 1, we'll divide the entire row by the constant 2. So your R1 changes to lambda. Your lambda will be equal to 1 by A11. If you divide by the scalar A11, if A11 is not equal to 1, you can divide the row 1 by the scalar A11 to make it 1. So now it became 1. A12 will be something scalar, A13 will be something scalar. Suppose they are non-zero, a21, a22, a23, a31, a32, a33. This will be some matrix. It will, row 1 will be transformed into some other row and into A. We will not write these things. Okay, automatically it will change. Now we have found A11 is equal to 1. Step 2 will be, using row 1 will make A21 and A31 is equal to 0. Make A21 is equal to 0 by using, see, if I write row 2 changes to row 2 plus minus A21 into row 1. See, I have multiplied a constant minus A21 in the row 1 and then I added this to row 2. So I'll get A21 minus A21, it will be 0. And similarly, make A31 is equal to 0 by using the operation R3 changes to R3 plus minus A31 into R1. Now I have used a similar operation here. I have multiplied the row 1 by the constant minus A31, it is 1. So if I multiply by minus 31, it is minus A31. So if I add R1 with R3, I will get 0 in the first element of row 3. So make A31 is equal to 0 by using this operation. And to make A21 is equal to 0, use this operation. So we have found 100. A22 will be something, A33 will be something, A12, A13, A23, A33. See, if I use these operations here, automatically this matrix will change to another matrix B. Okay, we no need to worry for this matrix. If your calculations are correct, you'll get a accurate result. Okay, so this is 1, this is 0, this is 0. Now your main motto is to make it 1. Step 3, make A22 is equal to 1. So you can make A22 is equal to 1 by using two processes. First process is by using, you can simply divide row 2 by the constant A22. See, I wrote R2 changes to 1 by A22 into R2. That is, I multiplied the row 2 by the constant 1 by A22, or I can say I have divided row 2 by the constant A22. Or you can use row 2 plus lambda into row 3. Using R3, you can convert this into 1, because for example, if it is 7 and if it is 3, if I multiply row 3 by the constant 2, I'll get 6. Now if I subtract, what is 7 minus 6? It is equal to 1. So I can use row 3 to make A22 also 1. So this is 100. Now it is again 1. I will get A12. This is something constant. A32. There will, see, I have just calculating the elements A11 here, A21 here, A31 here. Okay. So A12, A32 will be some constants. 1, 3. If you get 0 here, then it's a blessing. A23 and A33. It will be automatically transformed into some other matrix. Now your step 4 will be, make A120 by using R1 changes to R1 plus minus A12 into R2. See, I have multiplied the rho 2 by the constant minus a 1 2. If it is 5, I will multiply 1 by minus 5, so I will get 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. It is 0, 1 plus 5 into 0, it is always 1. It will be something else, some constant. And make a 3 2 is equal to 0 by using R3 is equal to R3 plus minus A32 into R2. Again, I have multiplied rho 2 by the constant minus A32, and then I have added this with the elements of rho 3. So I will get 0 here. So your matrix A transformed into 1, 0, 0. This is 1, this is 0, this is 0. This is some constant A13, A23. This is again 1, A33. So I have found 100, 100. Now your motto is to make it 1, then make them 0. Now this is A33. So your main motto is to make it 1, make them zeros. Okay. So after using operations on the right side, so left side, the matrix on the right side will be automatically transferred into another matrix B. Your step 5 is make A33 is equal to 1. Now you have only one operation left by using R3 is equal to 1 by A33 into R3. See, I have divided the rho 3 by the constant A33 to make it 1. So we'll get 100010. This is 1. This will be some scalar A23. This is A13. Automatically, your matrix I3 on the right side will be changed to another matrix B. After getting A33 is equal to 1, using your rho 3, we have to make the elements A13 and A23 is equal to zeros. So make A13 is equal to 0 by using the operation. See, I will write R1 changes to R1 plus, I will multiply the rho 3 by the constant minus A13 into rho 3 and make A23 is equal to 0 by using R2 is equal to R2 plus minus A23 into R3. So we'll get 100010. 001, and you will get a matrix B on the right side, which will be is equal to your A inverse. A into B is equal to I3, so it will be called your A inverse. Using this procedure, you can find the inverse of any matrix without wasting too much time. Now I will show you an example of finding A inverse using elementary row operation using this procedure. We are given find A inverse where A is equal to 1, 3, minus 2, minus 3, 0, minus 5, 2, 5, 0. We need to find the A inverse. So first we can write A is equal to, your A is equal to 1, 3, minus 2, minus 3, 0, minus 5, 2, 5, 0. This is I means 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 into the matrix A. So we will operate in the matrix A of the left side and matrix I on the right side. Now our main motto is to make it 1. See, it is 1, so it's a blessing. we no need to use the step 1, it is already 1. So we'll start with step 2, we'll make them 0 and make them 0. So we will write, you can use separate steps for row 2 and row 3, but I will use in a single step. So first you can write row 2 changes to row 2 plus c. This is minus 3. To make it 0, I have to use plus 3 here. So I will multiply your row 1 by the constant 3. Here it is minus 3, so I multiply by the constant plus 3. 3 into 1, it is 3. Minus 3 plus 3 is 0. And similarly, your row 3, in row 3 I have 2. So I'll multiply here by minus 2. So I can write row 3 changes to row 3 plus minus 2 into row 1. So after using operation, you'll get the elements as 1, 3, minus 2. See, you have to calculate these operations on the rough, because otherwise you may calculate wrongly. So if there is any miscalculation, your result will be different from others. So minus 3 row 2 minus 3 plus minus 3 into 1, it is 0. 0 plus 3 into 3, it is 9. Minus 5 plus 3 into minus 2, minus 11. Now row 2, row 3, R3, 2 plus minus 2 into 1, it is 0. 5 plus minus 2 into 3, this is 5 plus minus 2 into 3, 5 minus 6, it is minus 1. Next, this is your 0, 0 plus minus 2 into minus 2, this is plus 4. We'll operate on the right side to 1, 0, 0. You are changing row 2 by row 2 plus 3 into R1. 0 plus 3 into 1, it is 3. 1 plus 3 into 0, it is 1. And 0 plus 3 into 0, it is again 0. And for row 3 is equal to row 3 plus minus 2 into R1. So 0 plus minus 2 into 1, minus 2. 0 plus minus 2 into 0, it is 0. And 1 plus minus 2 into 0, it is 1. Into A. So this is my step 2. Now make it 0. Make this element 1. Now make this element 1. You can use two methods. You can divide by 9 or you can use row 3. So if I write row 2 changes to, see, this is 9. If I multiply by 8 in the row 3, I'll get minus 8. What is 9 minus 8? It is 0. So if I write row 2 changes to row 2 plus 8 into row 3. See, I have multiplied row 3 by the constant 8. So I am getting 0 into 8, 0. Minus 1 into 8, minus 8. And 8 4 is 32. If I add this with row 2, I will get 1, 3, minus 2. 0 plus 8 into 0, 0. 9 plus 8 into minus 1, minus 8. 9 minus 8, 1. Minus 11 plus 8 into 4, minus 11 plus 32, plus 21. Now it is 0, minus 1 and 4. Similarly, you operate on the right side. This is 1, 0, 0, 3. 3 plus minus 8 into 2. 3 minus 16, this is minus 13. 1 plus minus 8 into 0, this is 1. And 0 plus 8 into 1, it is 8. Minus 2, 0, 1. Now, make minus 1 is equal to 0 and 3 is 0. In place of 3 and minus 1, we need to get 0 and 0. So, how to make them 0? This is row 1, in row 1 I have 3. So if I multiply row 2 by the constant minus 3 and I add, I will get 0. So row 1 changes to minus 3 into row 2. And similarly for this, see, this is minus 1. If I add plus 1 here, I will get 0.
So I can write rho 3 changes to rho 3 plus 1 into rho 2. I have multiplied by the constant 1 here because it is already 1. So minus 1 plus 1, it is 0. So 1, 0, 0. This is 1 plus minus 3 into 0. This is 1. 3 plus minus 3 into 1, it is 0. Minus 2 plus minus 3 into 21, this is minus 65. Minus 2 plus minus 3 into 21, minus 3 into 1, minus 63, minus 2, minus 65, this is 1, this is 21, and for this rho 3 will be equal to rho 3, add them, 0 plus 0, it is 0, minus 1 plus 1, it is 0, 21 plus 4, this is 25. This is, now operate here, R1 is equal to 100, so we have to multiply rho 2 by the constant minus 3, this is minus 3, so minus 3 into minus 13, minus 39 plus 1, this is 40. And then this is 0, 0 plus minus 3 into 1, this is minus 3. 0 plus minus 3 into 8, minus 24, minus 13, 1, it is 8. Now for rho 3, we have to add rho 3 with rho 2, minus 13, minus 2, minus 15, this is 0 plus 1, it is 1, and what is 1 plus 8, it is 9. So 100, 100, now your main motto is to make it 1. So I can write rho 3 changes to 1 by 25 into rho 3. I have divided rho 3 by the constant 1 by 25. So I am getting 10 minus 65, 01, 21 and 001. Similarly, 40 minus 3 minus 24. Minus 13, 1, 8, minus 15 by 25. If I divide by 25, I will get minus 15 by 25. That means if I divide by 25, it will be 3 by 5, 1 by 25. This is 9 by 25. Okay, now this is my rho 3. We need to make them 0, need to make them 0. So I will write rho 1 changes to rho 1 plus, this is minus 65. If I multiply by plus 65 here, I will get 65 into R3. And similarly, your rho 2 will be equal to rho 2 plus minus 21 into R3. It is 21, so I will multiply by minus 21, I will add the elements, I'll get 0. So upon calculation, I'll get 100010, because these elements are 0, it will not bother anything. So 001. Now calculate this. For this, I will suggest you to use the rough page of the paper. So this is R1 is equal to R1 plus 65 into R3. So if you add 40, see here, 40 plus 65 into your R3 is equal to minus 3 by 5. So if you calculate by 5, 13, minus 39 plus 40, this is plus 1. Okay. Now next is R1 is minus 3 plus 65 into 1 by 25. Your next step is R1 plus 65 into R3, so minus 3 plus 65 into 1 by 25. So again divide by 5, I will get 13, this is 5. Now multiply 5, 3 is minus 15 plus 13 minus 2, this is minus 2 by 5. And your next step is
minus 24 plus 65 into 9 by 25. Again, divide by 5. I'll have 5. This is 13. 5 24 is minus 120 plus 117. This is 3 by 5. See, if you have good calculation skills, you can easily find without using this rough sheet. But I will suggest you to use the rough work process. Next is R2 is equal to R2 plus minus 21 into R3. So this is minus 21 into, minus 13 plus minus 21 into R3. R3 is minus 3 by 5. Take LCM, 5 13 just 65. Minus 65 plus 63. This is minus 2 by 5. Next will be 1 plus minus 21 into 1 by 25. Take LCM. This is 4 by 25. And next is 8 plus minus 21 into 9 by 25. So I will calculate 200 minus 189. I will have 11 by 25. 11 by 25. So your result will be into a, I forgot to write a, so 100010001. So a into b is equal to I, so you can write a inverse is equal to 1 minus 2 by 5 3 by 5 minus 2 by 5 4 by 25 11 by 25 minus 3 by 5, 1 by 25, 9 by 25, which is your A inverse. So, I have used only 6 steps here. Actually, 5 steps, because your A11 is already 1. So, we didn't do the step 1. So, using maximum 6 or 7 steps, you can easily find the A inverse of any square matrix using this procedure. It will be minus 3. So using this procedure, you can easily find the inverse of any square matrix without any problem. So